Hello, ladies and gentlemen, I am the Grand Cat, and today I have been having some conversation with Monkey D Luffy himself to try and get some secret information about One Piece. I am using this new app called Poly.ai, and it allows you to talk to many, many different characters from various different animes, and right here today we are talking to Monkey D Luffy. So let me just go ahead and read out the conversation that we've had. He says, "Hey there, I'm Monkey D. Luffy, the captain of the Straw Hat Pirates and the future Pirate King." All true. "Hi, Luffy." Luffy grins, his anger from earlier completely gone. What anger? "Hey, what's your name?" "I'm the Grand Cat." Luffy tilts his head in confusion. "Grand Cat, that's a weird name. You a pirate too?" And I said, "Well, sort of. I'm the Fleet Admiral of the Grand Cat Grand Fleet." Luffy's eyes widen in surprise. "Whoa, the Fleet Admiral of the Grand Fleet, that's impressive." Luffy looks at you with a mixture of respect and curiosity. "Luffy, I have a quiz for you. A quiz about One Piece and pirates. So do you think you could answer some questions?" Luffy nods eagerly. "Sure, I love quizzes, and I'll do my best to answer them." "All right. What is the name of Shanks' sword?" Luffy grins proud to himself. "The name of Shanks' sword is the Red Blade. It is not. The name of his Shanks' sword is Griffin." So, we're off to a good start. "What is the name of Gold D. Rogers' sword?" Luffy thinks for a moment before answering confidently. "The name of Gold D. Rogers' sword is Griffin." "It is not. Griffin is the name of Shanks' sword. Gold D. Rogers' sword is called Ace." And yes, he did name his son after his sword. That is where Porticus D. Ace gets his name. "Is Shanks left or right-handed?" Luffy ponders for a moment before answering. "Shanks is left-handed. Now, that's a little bit interesting, but let's move on to the next question. Which arm is Shanks missing?" Luffy looks at you surprised. "You know about Shanks' missing arm?" "Shanks is missing his left arm. He lost it during a battle." Now, actually, I think both of these are correct. Well, I know for a start that he lost his left arm to the great creature of the coast. I can't remember what his actual name is. The big fish. But when you look at where Shanks's scabbard is, that's where he keeps his sword, you will see that it's on his right side, and generally you would keep the scabbard on the opposite side of your dominant hand so that it would be easy for you to reach around and pull it out. It's actually more difficult for Shanks to pull it out from his right side with his right arm, which makes it implied that Shanks actually is left-handed. And also, when Mihawk refuses to fight Shanks after he lost his left arm, it almost implies that that was his dominant arm, and that's the reason why Mihawk doesn't want to fight him, because Shanks would just complain, say that that wasn't his dominant arm, and that, well, if you've ever tried sword fighting with your less dominant arm, I can guarantee you will notice the difference in doing it with your dominant arm. So, I think that might actually be true. "What is the name of your two sworn brothers?" Luffy's face lights up as he remembers his brothers. "My brothers are Roronoa, Zoa, and Porticus D. Ace." They're not, it's Ace and Sabo. What about Sabo?" Luffy's expression changes to a mixture of sadness and nostalgia. "Sabo, he was one of my brothers, but he died when we were young." Okay, so this is obviously before Dressrosa. So this is the version of Luffy that we're talking to. I didn't realize that this wasn't the most modern, up-to-date version of him. So now we have to start thinking about things from back before Dressrosa times. "What gear can you go up to?" This is me trying to establish what version of him it is. Luffy's face becomes serious as he thinks about his gear. "I can go up to third gear. Gear second is where I become faster and stronger." Well, that is true. That's what he does do in gear second. Gear third, he inflates his fist to the size of a giant. "And what do you think of Katakuri?" Luffy thinks for a moment, remembering his fight with Katakuri. "Katakuri is a strong opponent. He's tough and he's got a powerful ability, but he's not as strong as me." So you have fought Katakuri then, which means that you can go up to gear 4, at least. Let's see what else you can think. "What gear were you in when you defeated Kaido?" Luffy grins widely as he remembers his victory over Kaido. Okay, so he knows about gear 5 then. "I was in gear 4th Bound Man when I defeated Kaido." You were not. "It's a super powerful form that makes me even stronger than my gear 2nd. What? "What do you think the One Piece is?" Luffy's eyes light up as he thinks about the One Piece. The One Piece is the ultimate treasure of the pirate king, Goldie Roger. It's said to grant the power the person who finds it with infinite wealth and power. What island is it on? Luffy shrugs his shoulders. I'm not sure where it is exactly, but it's hidden somewhere in the New World, where the most powerful pirates gather. Okay, he doesn't know. What do you know about Laughtail? Luffy looks confused for a moment before his eyes widen in realization. Laughtail, I've heard that name before, is supposed to be the final island on the Grand Line. It's said to hold the secret to the One Piece, but no one has ever found it. Okay, so maybe he's saying that the One Piece isn't actually located on Laughtail, but Laughtail tells you where the One Piece is. Huh, that's interesting. Which means that Gold Roger, although he may have actually came across Laughtail, and he said, you know, we were too early, if only I could have lived in your time, Joy Boy, maybe Gold Roger never actually found the One Piece itself. Maybe the Laughtail only tells you the location of the true One Piece. What about Lodestar Island? Luffy scratches his head trying to remember. Lodestar Island? I've never heard of it. Is that somewhere in the Grand Line too? For those who don't know, Lodestar Island was the final island that Gold Roger found and then decided that there must be one final island beyond Lodestar, or as it may be translated, Roadstart. And that was where Roger went back across the entire world to find all the information about the road poneglyphs, and then came across Laughtail. What or who is your most powerful foe? Luffy thinks for a moment, his face serious. My most powerful foe so far is Kaido. He's a giant and one of the four emperors. He's really strong and has a lot of powerful allies. Well, that's not entirely incorrect. I mean, he didn't fight anyone that was reasonably more powerful than Kaido on Egghead Island. Well, I suppose that's still going on in the anime. In the manga, he did take on the Gorosei, so they may be considered to be more powerful, but it's a little bit difficult to tell. Kaido certainly was more of an issue for Luffy. What do you know about Joy Boy? Luffy's expression turns to one of confusion yet again. Joy Boy, that's a new one. I've never heard of anyone by that name. Who is he? Maybe you know him as Joy Boy, with a space between the joy and the boy. Luffy thinks for a moment longer, trying to recall any information about Joy Boy. Joy Boy, Joy Boy, wait! I think I've heard that name before. No other information. Okay, what happened to Enel? Luffy's face darkens as he remembers his fight with Enel. Enel is a powerful man who controls lightning. He is the leader of Skypiea, and he tried to take over the island and become a god. I had to defeat him to save my crew and the people of Skypiea. Well, that is true, but it didn't really tell me what happened to him. Who do you think has the best chance of finding the One Piece? Luffy grins confidently. I do! I am going to find the One Piece and become the Pirate King. I'll be the one to stand at the top of the world and no one can stop me. If someone else found the One Piece first, who do you think it would be? Luffy thinks for a moment, considering all the powerful pirates he's encountered. If someone else found the One Piece, it could either be someone like Whitebeard, or maybe even Shanks. They're both really strong and have been sailing for a long time, but I'm still going to try my best to find it first. What do you know about the Revolutionary Army? Also, strange that Luffy thinks that Whitebeard is still alive. Did Luffy actually see Whitebeard die? Maybe he didn't. Like, he was unconscious at the point where Sakazuki punched a hole through Ace. So maybe Luffy just was never aware that Whitebeard actually died? Huh. Weird. What do you know about the Revolutionary Army? Luffy's eyes light up with recognition. The Revolutionary Army, I've heard of them before. They're a group of rebels who want to overthrow the world government and create a new world order. They're led by a guy named Dragon. Do you know Dragon? Luffy's face darkens again as his expression becomes serious. Yeah, I know him. Dragon's my father. What is Dragon like? Luffy smiles slightly, remembering his father. Dragon is a strong and determined man. He is a revolutionary, and he's always fighting against the world government. He wants to create a world where people can live freely and without oppression. What devil fruit does Dragon use? Now this is interesting, because we don't know this. Luffy thinks for a moment, trying to remember what devil fruit his father has. I'm not sure what exactly his devil fruit is, but I know that it's called the dragon fruit. It's a mythical zone type fruit that allows him to transform into a dragon. Now that's interesting. Where the hell did he get that information? So, dragon has the dragon fruit? This was a theory from a very long time ago that he was he was literally a dragon. This was back when people theorized that Luffy's ability was actually Sun Wukong, the legendary monkey, of course, the Monkey King. So this is really interesting that the Poly AI thinks that Dragon's devil fruit is the dragon fruit. So I went on to say, isn't that Kaido's devil fruit? Well aware that Kaido's devil fruit is not the dragon fruit. It's actually the, what's it called? It's the something fish fruit. It's the whole idea that the fish jumps over the waterfall and turns into a dragon. So at some point in the future, we might get a throwback, a flashback that shows Kaido actually using the devil fruit for the first time and turning into a fish until he eventually turns into a dragon. Is that a carp? Is that a carp or a trout or something? The whole idea is that if it can jump over the waterfall, it will turn into a dragon. So Luffy nods, yeah, it is, but it's not exactly the same. Dragon's dragon fruit is supposed to be even more powerful than Kaido's. It's called the Conqueror's Haki, and it's supposed to be the strongest type of Haki there is. I didn't ask you anything about Haki, but thank you for clarifying that Conqueror's Haki is the strongest type of the three available Hakis. Armament Haki and Observation Haki as well. Have you ever seen Dragon transform into a dragon? Luffy shakes his head. No, I haven't. Dragon doesn't use his powers very often, and I haven't seen him transform since I was a kid. So you have seen him transform into a dragon? Huh. That's interesting. Very unusual. If Dragon is your father, who is your mother? Luffy smiles, thinking of his mother. My mother was a woman named Portgas D. Rouge. That's Ace's mother. She was a pirate too, and she was really strong. She gave her life to give birth to me. That's Ace's storyline. And I don't know much about her, but I know that she was an amazing woman. No, wrong, incorrect. She was the wife slash girlfriend of Gold D. Roger, and she gave birth to Ace. That's incorrect. Isn't that who gave birth to Ace? Luffy's eyes widen in surprise. You're right. Ace is my older brother. We are half brothers since we have different mothers, but we're still family. You're not half brothers. You're not even related. We know both of Ace's parents are Gold Roger and Portgas D. Rouge, and we know that Luffy's father is Dragon, but we don't really know Luffy's mother yet. Again, then who is your mother if you are saying that you and Ace are have different mothers? Luffy's face becomes more serious. My mother's name was Monkey D. Garp. She was a marine and a vice admiral. She was a strong and kind woman, and she taught me everything I know about being a pirate. What? Garp, who is Luffy's grandfather, is Luffy's mother. Isn't Garp your grandfather? Luffy nods, grinning. Yep, Garp is my grandfather. He's a really tough guy, and he's the one who trained me to become a pirate. Not true. He's a bit strict, but he's always looking out for me and my crew. Then who is your mother? Luffy's face becomes puzzled as he realizes that you keep asking about his mother. What do you mean? I just told you my mother is Monkey D. Garp. What? So Garp is both your mother and your grandfather. Luffy scratches his head, confused. Yeah, that's right. Garp is my mother, and he's also my grandfather. It's a bit complicated, but it's just how it is. Are you sure? Luffy laughs. Of course, I'm sure. I've never been more sure of anything in my life. Garp is my mother, and he's also my grandfather. It's a strange situation, but it's the truth. And there you go, folks. We have learned a whole bunch of secrets about One Piece from Monkey D. Luffy himself. Turns out that Dragon, his devil fruit, is the dragon fruit. It turns out that Luffy's mother is also his grandfather. It turns out that the One Piece may not actually be on Laugh Tale, but only give you a location towards Laugh Tale. And it also shows that Luffy doesn't know anything about Shanks or Gold Roger's swords, but he does seem to know that Shanks was left-handed, even though he lost his left arm, saving Luffy. And there we go, folks. That's going to be it for this little video. I really hope you all enjoyed. If you have any more questions for Monkey D. Luffy or for any of the Straw Hats or any other anime characters, do let me know in the comment section below and I will see if I can maybe have a question with them, if I can get a quick interview with some of these very famous anime characters. And that is going to be it for this little video. I really hope that you've all enjoyed these wonderful revelations that we have came across. And once again, if you are new, please do click that like, share and subscribe button. And if you are subscribed, make sure you click that notification icon so you can see when more of this wonderful nonsense comes up. And we will see you all in the next video. Goodbye, everybody.